Your name is Larry. Larry Laffer. You've arrived in beautiful Lost Wages without luggage. The airline lost it. Without a hotel reservation, you forgot to get one. And without a clue. You've never had one. You exit the cab. The hot, dry air of Lost Wages hits you in the face like a hard slap. A feeling not wholly unfamiliar to you. After your cab ride, you may be low on funds, but you've got the looks, the lines, and the leisure suit. You're in town to find true love. And if you happen to get lucky along the way, that's okay. After all, you're nearly 40.
And still untouched by human hands. Look out, ladies. I'm finding love tonight.
It's you, Larry. Larry Laffer. Remember? It feels like a building, only stickier.
Echo!
The sound bounces around in your head for a few seconds.
Awesome!
You lick yourself.
Oh my god! I taste good! Speaking objectively, of course.
You quickly check your fly by zipping it up and down a few times.
Zips up, zips down in an instant for easy access. Yeah, baby!
Somebody's offering a reward for the return of a lost Bernese mountain lion. And a local band called Rosella and the Iceman is opening for the Captain and Tennille next week. You inhale her scent.
I'm sorry to just blurt this out, but you smell absolutely incredible. It's as if your inner light is so serene and pure that your aura has its own sweet and almost hypnotic aroma.
I had tapioca for lunch.
What's a hot babe like that doing in a miserable, smelly, broken-down joint like this?
Hey, bub, just keep that kind of narration to yourself.
It feels oddly generic, as if you felt something just like it before, elsewhere. You pick up lefties, but realizing that you have no place to put it, you gently set it back right where you got it. The dart simulation plugin was out of our price range. Whoever decided that darts is the perfect game for drunks deserves a medal. First rule of socializing, Larry. Look at the person you're trying to engage with, particularly when they helped pay for you to be here. He smells like loneliness. Maybe that's why he seems so familiar. Be polite, Larry. Look at the man first. He's one of Lost Wages' finest benefactors. That's Jordan Lee. He's here frequently, and they say he shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. Curiously, in Florida, Arizona, and Montana, just to watch him die is a valid legal defense against homicide.
Hey, loser! Want to go get into some serious fucking trouble?
Hey! No!
That's a shame. I know some major going down tonight. It's gonna be awesome.
That sounds boss.
No, it doesn't. He looks like someone from your distant past, but you just can't put your finger on him.
Good thing, too.
The gentleman filling his face is Tom King, a regular at Lefty's and the kind of guy you love to have with you at the movies, so you don't have to talk to him for 2 hours.
Looking at me?
Can't blame you, actually. I got that handsome roguish look. It's a curse. But hey, you know what I mean, right?
Of course I do.
Yeah, I'm sure you know lots of handsome guys in my situation.
This international bon vivant, François de Keet, is one of Lefty's big investors. And being from Europe, he's extremely cool.
Wow, you're cool!
I know, right? It's almost too cool how cool I am, n'est-ce pas?
Ooh, and you speak Klingon, too!
No, I don't think so.
I resent your chiseled features, your height, and your easygoing, laid-back demeanor. Can I have your life?
No, I have too much cool to fit into that little body.
You rap loudly on the Naugahyde door.
Yeah? What's the password?
Swordfish?
Damn fool, have some originality.
An eye peers back with suspicion through the peephole.
You must be tired. You've been running through my mind all day.
I know, but you keep following me anyway.
Sorry if this sounds a little squirrely, baby, but I'd like to store you in my cheek pouches for a snowy day.
Really? I'd like to crack your skull like a nut and bury your brains in the park.
Alrighty then! We're really starting to make a connection, eh?
I wish it was long distance.
You must be tired. You've been running through my mind all day.
I know.
You slip a buck into the jukebox and search for a suitably sleazy selection. This is the famous portrait, Mona Little Louder. It's better to remain silent and be thought a fool than to speak and remove all doubt that you're Larry. Unfortunately, the painting isn't scratch and sniff, but you're not the first person to try.
I bet that horseshoe's up there for luck.
Yeah, but it ain't working. You're here.
That's either a moose or the world's biggest mutant jackalope. One of Lefty's conquests? He appears to be perverted, twisted, and sick. You instantly take a liking to him. Allowing you to use the darts would pose an unacceptable risk to the computer-controlled characters. You pound on the bar, but Lefty ignores you. Maybe you need to actually engage him in conversation. Have a seat at the bar first. What do you think this is? Some dive even cruddier than this? You give yourself a quick...
Got my walk. Come and get me, ladies!
You give yourself a quick pat-down.
Got my wallet. Come in.
You pound on the bar, but Lefty... You take a seat on an available bar stool.
Sorry if this sounds a little squirrely, baby, but I'd like to store you in my cheek pouches for a snowy day.
Really? I'd like to crack your skull like a nut and bury your brains in the...
Alrighty then! Hello?
What'll it be?
Give me a mug of beer.
You flip $5 onto the counter. You down the beer in your pseudo-macho style and slam the mug back on the bar. Suddenly, you feel a little woozy.
Hello?
What'll it be?
I'll have a glass of your fine well whiskey.
That'll be $5, please.
You flip $5 onto the counter. You don't drink the whiskey, but instead decide to carry it with you wherever you go, precariously balanced in an open shot glass. You feel a little lightheaded. You're unsure if you'll be able to walk straight. Shaking your head, you finally clear away the cobwebs and are once again able to walk in your standard studly style. You give yourself a quick pat.
Got my walk.
Comment.
You pick up. You run your finger up and down her knee.
Excuse me. Did I tell you you could touch me?
You said it with your eyes.
Next time, get confirmation from my mouth first. Okay, loser.
Ooh, so it'll be a next time?
You give the babe another deep whiff.
I'm sorry, I just have to say it again. You smell amazing. You smell like cotton candy, a warm day on the beach, soft flannel sheets, and spring all rolled into one.
Radio Girl perfume. $2 a gallon at Woolworths.
We're really starting to make a connection, eh?
Oh, I wish it was long distance.
You are in a dimly lit hallway. The peeling wallpaper gives the roaches something to watch. Clutter fills the room, and a filthy drunk wearing filthy clothes sits on the filthy floor, leaning his filthy back against the filthy wall. It's a beer sign playing off the Bush beer slogan, Bush beer gives you great head, swallow after swallow.
Hey, don't touch your merchandise. I'm not your cabin boy anymore.
He must have an interesting past. You try to pull up the rug. Not only doesn't it move, it's incredibly sticky as well. You shudder to think what's glued it to the floor. He is a poor little lamb who has lost his way, and also his bladder control. Wanting to be humane to the drunk, you clap him firmly on the shoulder, stroke his head, pat his hand, and get up close to him.
So tell me, how are you doing?
Ah, thanks for asking, buddy. I'd be just great if only my impetigo would clear up.
The lamp is useless without its shade, or even with it. It's a girly lamp like you'd find in any swingin' bachelor's rumpus room. You deftly pluck the rose from the vase and carry it with you.
Yeah, baby!
This delicate bud vase once contained a single red rose. Now it's as empty as your life. You have no use for the bud vase itself. You already have plenty of filth at home. This door is permanently nailed shut. You'll just have to wait for a sequel to find out what's behind it. You can't open it. It just hangs there mocking you. Of course, you're used to things just hanging there mocking you. You look closely in the mirror.
In this light, I can really see the blackheads. All right!
Why, look, some woman removed her diamond ring to wash her hands and forgot to take it with her. Score! Piles of magazines sit on the floor. The magazines have already seen their share of those.
I'm just wasting my breath talking to you, aren't I?
You start to wash your hands in the cold water. Then you realize that there's no soap, Then you realize that there are no paper towels, so you wash your hands as well as you can and wipe them on the back of your shirt, under your jacket where the wet spots won't show. You give yourself a quick pat-down.
Got my wallet, got my breath spray. Coming.
You scrape the...
Wow! Scratch and sniff!
You're already well wiped. Thank God. You grab an ancient copy of Flutter, the magazine of nude skydiving, and settle in to sit and think. You feel a great relief. What's that aroma? Carefully finishing your duties, you wipe and toss the newspaper behind the toilet for the next user. Don't do it, Larry! Too late! The toilet begins to fill. Realizing your mistake, you quickly jiggle the handle, attempting to stem the onrushing tide of water. As the water reaches your head, your life flushes before your eyes. You doze briefly. Turns out, a flush beats everything. Sometimes good manners are a bad idea, eh, Larry? You can't open it. Of course, you're...
Did something die in there?
You try to pull up the rope. This isn't one of those fish that flops and sings. It just hangs there and you can't do anything with it. A feeling not entirely unfamiliar to you. The ratalope doesn't do anything. It just observes and quietly judges.
Hey, dork. You got toilet paper stuck to your shoe. Ha ha
ha. It's you, Larry. You give yourself.
Got my wallet, got my breath. Coming.
Your generous offer of a beautiful rose nets you one raised eyebrow, nothing more. Apparently, this person isn't into botany. It's not good etiquette to drink standing up. Your offering of whiskey invokes a look of disdain. You can't just walk around proposing to everyone. Wait till someone asks you for a ring. You don't owe any money right now. It's better to remain silent and be thought a fool than to speak and remove all doubt that you're Larry.
You know, you must be my only friend in the whole world. So, I'm gonna give you all I got in the world. Besides, what's a guy like me need with a coaster? I mean, what am I, high society?
Yeah, baby!
Hey, don't touch your merchandise. I'm not your cabin boy anymore.
He must have an interesting past.
Hey, don't tell-
He must have an imp-